Hello students, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Last video we are discussing about speed, average speed, instantaneous speed. So these three are depending on the distance of the object with respect to time. After that we are discussing about velocity. So velocity is depending on the displacement of the object with respect to time. So speed is a which type of the quantity? Is maybe scalar or vector? So speed has only magnitude, it has no direction, so speed is a scalar quantity. What about the velocity? Velocity has both magnitude as well as direction, so velocity is a vector quantity. We are already discussed. In this video, we are discussing about graphs of the velocity, okay? Graphs. For example, a car travel 40 meters displacement in 8 seconds, for example. I am drawing the graph 40 meter 8 second. Okay. Graph has x axis and y axis. This is the x axis. This is the y-axis, this is the horizon, okay. Along x-axis, I am taking the time values, units, second. Along y-axis, I am taking the displacement, units are meter, okay. So, time 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Displacement 5 meter, 10 meter, 15 meter, 20 meter, 25 meter, 30 meter, 35 meter, 40 meter. Maximum is 40 meter, maximum time is 8 seconds, for example. At 0 seconds, the car travel distance is 0 meter, so point is here. At 1 second, the car travel distance is 5 meter. At 2 seconds, the car travel distance is 10 meter. At 3 seconds, the car travels is 15 meter. 4 seconds, 20 meter, 5 seconds, 25 meter, 6 seconds, 30 meter, 7 seconds, 35 meter, 8 seconds, 40 meter. Okay? I am joining all the points. The graph is straight line. Okay? This is the graph. Displacement versus time, and also called as x versus t graph. X means displacement is denoted by a letter x, time is denoted by a letter t. So this graph is also called as the x versus t graph. From this graph, we are going to calculate the velocity of the object. How to find the velocity from the graph? By using the slope. Okay, first of all, draw the slope between any two points. 25 is the final value, 15 is the initial value. So 25, 15. Okay, You can take any 2 points, but I am taking the 15 and 25. Along x-axis values are 3, 5. Okay. Now, slope formula. What is the slope formula? Y-axis along y-axis values means y2 minus y1 by along x-axis, x2 minus x1, okay? Along y-axis by along x-axis values. So, first of all, along y-axis values are final value is the 25. Final value is 25. Initial value is the 15 meter displacement of the object. And along x-axis values, this is the initial, this is the final. Okay. 5 minus 3. 5 is the final point value, 3 is the initial value of the time of the object. On numerator, 25 minus 15, 10. On denominator, 5 minus 3, 2. Okay. 5 meter per second is the velocity of the object value. Okay. Which is positive value. This is called positive velocity graph. Are understand? From the slope, we can easily calculate the velocity of the object between any 2 points. Here, object travel from position A to B is 0 meters to 40 meters, it gives the positive value. Now, same car travel the position B to A means 40 meters to 0. Okay? 40 meters to 0. 40 meters travel in 8 seconds. But it is position B to A. First graph is A to B position, here B to A means the object is travel in opposite direction. So graph, along x-axis, along y-axis, origin O. Along x-axis, time t, units are second. Along y-axis, displacement, units are meter. Okay. Along x-axis values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Along y-axis, 5 meter, 10 meter, 15 meter, 20 meter, 25 meter, 30 meter, 35 meter, 40 meter. Okay? At time t is equal to 0, the object at 40 meter. Okay? This is the point. At 1 second, the object at 35 meter. The object is travel from B to A, so the distance is coming from 40 meters to 0 meter. So at 1 second, 35 meter, 2 seconds, 30 meter, 3 seconds, 20, 5 meter, 4 seconds, 20 meter, 5 seconds, 15 meter, 6 seconds, 10 meter, 7 seconds, 5 meters. The graph is decreasing gradually. Okay. Decreasing gradually. For this graph, I am going to calculate the velocity of the object. How to calculate the velocity of the object from the graph? Simply by using the slope. 30 meter, 15 meter. This is the slope. These are the y-axis values. Along x-axis values are 2, 5. Okay. So here initial point is 30 meter, final point is 15 meter. Okay. What is the slope formula? Slope equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Along y-axis, displacement values, along x-axis, time values. So, along y-axis, displacement values are, final value is 15 minus initial value is 30. Similarly, time, final value is 5, initial value is 2. Okay, on numerator, 15 minus 30 is the minus 15 value, 5 minus 3, 3. Minus 5 meter per second. Okay, here velocity value is minus 5 meter per second. Actual velocity value is 5 meter per second. Negative symbol is indicated for the car is travel in opposite direction, means B to A, position B to A. So here negative value is indicated for the object or the car is traveling opposite direction. Velocity is 5 meter per second. So velocity is represented magnitude as well as direction. It moving in straight or opposite direction, it will be indicated velocity. So this is called negative graph. Okay, this is called negative graph. First one is positive graph, this is the negative graph. Next graph, displacement versus time, x-axis, y-axis, origin O. Along x-axis, time units are second. Along y-axis, displacement meter along y-axis. So along x-axis values 0, 1, 2 seconds, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Along y-axis 5, 10 meter, 15 meter, 20 meter, 25 meter, 30 meter, 35 meter, 40 meter. Okay, along y-axis. So the car travel at 0 seconds is 15 meter, at 1 second is also 15 meter, 2 seconds also 15 meter, 3 seconds also 15 meter, 4 seconds also displacement is 15 meter, 5 seconds 15 meter, 6 seconds is also 15 meter, 7 seconds is also 15 meter. I am joining all the points. this graph is represented for time is increases, but displacement is never changes. So it indicated for the object is in rest position. Okay. The object is in rest position. Three types of the graphs. First one is positive, second one is negative. This is the rest position of the graph in case of velocities. We are already discussed in case of speeds, average speed. Similarly, in case of velocities also, average velocity. Now we are discussing about average velocity. Okay. The ratio of total displacement of object upon total time is called average velocity. Because in case of speeds, the speed of the object is not constant. It may be increases or decreases. But in case of speed, has no direction. But in case of average velocity, velocity may be increases or decreases. But here, velocity is shown the direction of the object. Okay. So, average velocity total displacement by total time. Okay. So the main difference between average speed and average velocity is average velocity is a scalar quantity. It has no direction. But average velocity has direction. It is a vector quantity. It has both magnitude as well as the direction. That is the main difference between average velocity and average speed. So what about the units? SI unit. What is the SI unit? Meter per second. Next, another one unit is CGS unit. CGS unit. What about the CGS unit? Centimeter per second. In case of SI unit, total displacement units are meter. SI units for the time is second. In case of CGS unit, total displacement units are centimeter, total time units are second. Now, what are the differences between velocity and speed? Here, velocity, here, speed. First of all, what is meant by velocity? We are already discussed about the rate of change of displacement is called velocity. Okay. What about the speed? The distance travel by object upon time is called speed. Okay, that is the first difference between velocity and speed. Next one, it has both magnitude and direction. Okay. But here, in case of the speed, it has only magnitude. Okay. So it has both magnitude and direction. So it is a vector quantity. Third point, it is a vector quantity. Here, it has only magnitude, that's why this physical quantity is a scalar quantity. Okay, these are the main difference between velocity and speed. I hope you are understanding about the velocity graphs, positive and negative, and rest position of the graph. And also, what are the differences between velocity as well as the speed, and what about the average velocity with examples. Thank you for watching this video.